today I'm going to make a cheese stuffed chorizo beef burger in a jalapeno bun. And the ingredients I'm using today are strong white bread flour, some salt, some black pepper. We need some tomatoes. Of course, we need some pickled jalapenos or fresh. We need gherkins. We need some unsalted butter. Then we need some Mexicana original hot cheddar with jalapeno cheese. Then we are going to use 6 pork and chorizo sausages. Then we need some garlic powder. We need some iceberg lettuce. We need some white wine vinegar. Then we need some Aberdeen Angus minced beef. Then we need some paprika, maybe an onion. Then we need some mayonnaise made with free-range eggs, of course. Then some sweet pickle, some olive oil, a little bit of sugar. Then we need some dried yeast, some whole milk. Then we need some onion granules. Then we need some free range eggs, of course, free range. Then we need some French yellow classic yellow mustard. Yellow classic mustard, classic yellow mustard, and obviously we need some sesame seeds. Smash in. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now let's get started. Right, ladies and gentlemen, the first thing to do is add 500 grams of your very strong white bread flour to a large bowl. Smash in. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get yourself, I would say, about 50 grams of pickled jalapenos. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now finely chop your jalapenos like so. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get your jalapenos into the flour as well. Smash in. Whew, after that much work, time for a zippy. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now to your flour add about 50 grams of unsalted butter. Smash in. Right, ladies and gentlemen, to this add one sachet of dried yeast. And now add 1.5 tablespoons of salt. Smash in. To this add 2.5 tablespoons of sugar. And now add one free range egg. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now add 3 tablespoons of whole milk. And now add 1 tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil. Smash it. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now to this add about 220 milliliters of lukewarm water. Like so. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now grab your electric mixer and mix the dough for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Smash it! Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now when you have a really elastic but still sticky dough, cover with a clean tea towel and set aside for about maybe an hour or maybe two, or until doubled in size. Smashing. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and while you're waiting for your dough doubled in size, time for a zippy. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now when your dough has doubled in size, divide the dough into 6 equal pieces and obviously lightly flour your hands. And then shape it into a bun like so. And place it on a baking rack lined with baking paper. Smash it. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now cover your buns with a clean tea towel and let them double in size for about 45 minutes. Smash it. And while you're waiting for your buns, are doubling in size again, time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now we are halfway in to our proving process, just to show you the buns are nice and doubling in size, and now we are preheating our oven to 200 degrees Celsius, like so. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get yourself a kettle and bring some water to the boil, like so. Smash it. And while you're waiting for your water is coming up to the boil, it's time for a zippy. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get your boiled water into an oven-proof dish, like so. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and while you're waiting for your oven, it's getting preheated. Time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now grab yourself some milk into a bowl, then grab a brush and then carefully brush your buns. Be very gently, because you don't want to lose any air of the buns. And now sprinkle your buns with some sesame seeds. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, now get your buns in the oven. And bake for about 15 to 20 minutes. Smashing. And while you're waiting for your buns getting baked, time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, now when your buns are baked, get them out of the oven. And yeah, allow to rest a little bit. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, now make your sauce by using 370 grams of mayo. To this I'm adding 1 tablespoon of French yellow mustard. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now to this I'm adding 3 teaspoons of sweet pickle. And now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of onion granules. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of white wine vinegar. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now add 1 teaspoon of paprika. And now add 2 teaspoons of sugar. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and now give this a good stir, like so. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now put your sauce aside until needed. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now grab another bowl and to your bowl at 1 kilogram. Of Aberdeen Angus minced beef, and to this add 400 grams of your pork chorizo sausages. Get rid of the casings like so. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get your sausage and minced beef well mixed together. Get your clean hands in there, mix it. Make sure it's well distributed. Smash it. Ooh, after that much work, time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, now divide this stuff into 12 patties. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, now I'm lining my desk with my worst enemy. And it's not alcohol-free beer, It's cling film. I mean, I go free beer is worse, obviously. So now get your beef chorizo mix and make 12 patties. So grab your piece and make it into a patty like so. Smash in. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now grab your cheese. One slice of cheese on the first patty, then grab your second patty on top, and kind of close it. And give it a good shape, like so, and repeat with the remaining ones. Smash in. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and after that much work, time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now grab yourself a large frying pan and to this add about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And over a medium high heat, heat your oil. And while you're waiting for your oil, it's getting hot. Time for a zippy. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and when your oil is hot, get your patties into the frying pan like so. Smash it. And now fry them for about I would say 4 to 5 minutes each side. And while you're waiting for your patties are getting fried, time for a zippy. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now season your patties with a little bit of black pepper. And then season with a little bit of salt. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, after 4 minutes, turn them over. And fry for another 4 minutes. Smash it. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to season the patties with a bit of black pepper and obviously some salt. Okay. Right, right, ladies and gentlemen, and now get your patties out of the pan. Give them a quick flip. Righty right, ladies and gentlemen, and now it's time to plate up. Mm-hmm. first of all, grab your burger bun. And it's soft. Perfect. You can toast it if you want to. Then grab your sauce. Spread the sauce on the cut size of them. Then grab yourself some iceberg lettuce. Get rid of the outer leaves. And then get some iceberg on your, I would say, bottom bun. And now grab a patty . Get yourself some tomato. Slice up a tomato. Get it on the burger as well. And now grab some gherkins. Right, ladies and gentlemen, and here we have it, the cheese stuffed chorizo beef burger with a jalapeno bun. Looks okay. Always at this time, at this place, at this very moment, it's time for the tea. Bye-bye, and see you next time.